Hello and welcome to this session on selenium. Today we are going to learn what is selenium, what are the features of selenium, the four major components of selenium, and what are the browsers, operating systems, and languages supported by selenium. Let us begin. So selenium is a set of libraries that help us automate web browser actions. Let us go to our browser and type selenium. So you will get one of the options as seleniumsq.org, and this is the official website of Selenium. And if you go here, you will see the very first line says Selenium automates browsers. That's it. And once you get the power to automate a browser, the things you can do with it is actually unlimited. So let us take a very simple example. You want to test a login page. So you will enter the username, enter the password, and click on the login button. Now, if you want to automate this testing, you will download the Selenium libraries in any of your preferred programming languages, and using these libraries, you will create your test script, and the next time you want to test this login page, you will call these test scripts, and it will do all the actions for you. So at a very high level, you will be doing three things with Selenium. The first thing is, you will identify the web elements like text boxes, drop downs, and buttons on the web page where you want to work. And then you will add the actions in your preferred programming language along with the test data. And then you will run your test and validate. So Selenium is free and open source, and it is the most widely used solution for automation of web applications. Let us look at some of the features of Selenium. So Selenium is flexible and extensible. It has support for multiple languages and browsers. And if you go to the Selenium site and you go to download, and if you go down, you will find a lot of third-party plugins and add-ons available for Selenium. And there are a lot of plugins available. So you can extend Selenium and you can get a lot of functionalities in Selenium. Let us look at the four major components of Selenium. We have Selenium IDE, Selenium RC or Remote Control, WebDriver, and Selenium Grid. Selenium IDE is an add-on for Firefox, and it is a record and playback plugin, and you can use it for a prototype testing. Selenium Remote Control is also known as Selenium One, and it is used to execute your test scripts using JavaScript, and as of now it is not actively supported. Selenium WebDriver is the most actively used component today for frameworks, and it is an API which is used to interact directly with the browser, and it is also known as Selenium 2 now. Selenium Grid provides us the capabilities to run our test parallelly across different machines. So whenever you want to minimize the execution time, or you want to run your test cases on multiple platforms and browsers, you can use Selenium Grid. So in Selenium, these are the four major components: Selenium IDE, a record and playback plugin for Firefox; Selenium RC, known as Selenium One and not actively supported now; WebDriver; and then Selenium Grid. Let us also very quickly look at the key people in Selenium. So Selenium was started by Jason Huggins in 2004, and during his internal project, he wanted to create a testing suite, and he started working on this Selenium scripts. And then Selenium IDE was created by Shinya Kasatani of Japan. Selenium RC, the key person was Paul Hammond. And Simon Stewart was the key person in Selenium WebDriver. And Selenium Grid, the major contributor, was Patrick Lightbody. We will look deeply into these in the history of Selenium in some coming sessions. So Selenium RC is no longer supported and is deprecated. And Selenium RC and WebDriver are merged to form Selenium 2. We also have Selenium 3 now, released in October 2016. And if you go to your browser and type Selenium releases, you will get the official Selenium blog for the releases. And you can go here and you will see this blog about Selenium 3.0. So Selenium 3 is out now, and Selenium RC is no longer supported, and you will also not find a link to download Selenium RC now with Selenium 3. So what they have done is all the RC implementation is replaced with WebDriver compatible components. So if you want to have Selenium RC, you have to go to the previous releases. So if you go to the download sections of Selenium, you can go to the previous releases page, and here you can see 2.53 was the last version of Selenium 2, and then we have 3.0. So this is about Selenium 3. Let us very quickly look at very high level releases of Selenium. So in 2006 we had Selenium 1.0, where we had Selenium RC. In 2011 we got Selenium 2.0, where WebDriver came into picture, but Selenium RC was still there and actively supported. But in 2016 with Selenium 3.0, we do not have any active support for Selenium RC, and now we have WebDriver. We will look more into this in the history of Selenium. So these are the four major components. You can also go to the Selenium site and go to the project sections, where you will find details about these four components. Let us look at what are the browsers supported by Selenium. So Selenium supports all the major browsers, and also there are many more browsers that Selenium can support. You can actually go to the download page, and if you go down, you can find there are a lot of other browsers supported by third-party plugins, and you can also go to this page on platforms, which is seleniumhq.org about platforms, and you can see all these browsers. And if you go to this link, you can see there are a lot of browsers and different versions, and you can find the details here. So there are actually a lot of browsers than the major browsers. And again, when we talk about operating systems, all the major operating systems are supported, and then again we have others as well. So again, you can go to this particular link and go to the operating systems, and you will find all the operating systems supported by Selenium. When we talk about languages, Selenium provides us support in all the major languages, whether it is Java, Perl, PHP, C#, Python, Ruby, and again you can find other details on the Selenium about platforms page. So if you go to this platforms page, you will find all these languages supported, and you will also find information about the frameworks supported in each language. So if you are using Java, you have frameworks available like JUnit and TestNG for test management and so on. In every session, I will be giving you some helpful and useful tips. So for today, if you are a beginner in Selenium, you should go to Selenium HQ website, documentation and introduction, and read about it. So if you go to the Selenium HQ website, you have a link for documentation here. Just click here, and then you will click on this introduction link. And this is an article which you can read in less than 5 minutes, and it is a very nice article, and if you are a beginner, I suggest that you should go here and read about this introduction of Selenium. I hope we are now very clear with the concepts of Selenium, so we know what Selenium is, the features and the components of Selenium, and the browsers, OS and languages supported by Selenium. I will meet you in the next session. Thanks for watching.